Tonight, we go back to Woodsboro and revisit the original movie that kind of, what is it?
Scream!
In this episode of Blood and Brews, we go back to Woodsboro and revisit the film that kind of reinvented slasher films for the genre and kind of called out all the previous films for their shortcomings and whatever. Bullshit, I guess.
There are certain rules that one must abide by in order to successfully survive a horror movie. For instance, number one, you can never have sex.
Welcome to this episode of Blood and Brews. All right, so tonight
we watched Scream.
A horror mystery slash
comedy.
In my opinion, I mean, it had such a comedic feel throughout the entire film. Jamie Kennedy and Matthew Lillard, they fucking killed me. It was released in 1996.
And it's rated R?
Rated R with a runtime of 1 hour
and 40 minutes.
Starring Nev Campbell,
Courtney Cox,
David Arquette,
Skeet Ulrich,
Drew Barrymore,
Matthew Lillard, obviously.
Matthew fucking Lillard. Love him as Stu. Rose McGowan.
And Malibu's Most Wanted,
Jamie
Kennedy. The one and the only.
Okay. Alright, so tonight's film was about Sydney Prescott and her friends who were being terrorized.
Stricken.
By a fucking serial killer who is playing games with them, having to do with, like, horror films and stuff.
Like, so they use that as, stuff like that.
Yeah, they like, call them up and quiz them.
Want to play a game?
Exactly.
I ask a question. If you get it right, Steve lives.
Please don't do that.
Come on, it'll be fun.
Please.
It's an easy category.
Please.
Movie trivia. Or even give you a warm-up question.
Don't do this, I can't.
Name the killer in Halloween.
No.
Come on, it's your favorite scary movie, remember? He had a white mask, he stalked the babysitters.
No.
Come on, yes you
no.
do.
Please.
What's his name?
I can't.
Steve's counting on you.
Michael. Michael Myers.
Yes! Very good. Now for the real
question. It's pretty fucking interesting and cool, and I actually like the idea a lot. What did you think about the film? Like, say you had to rate it 1 to 10. I know that's our thing. What would you rate it and why?
I would say 7.5 because this movie has aged well. I remember seeing it when I was a lot younger, and I still was kind of like, oh wait, who the fuck was
it? I would also rate it about a 7 because I feel like it aged really well. As far as the fact that it was made in 1996, and it's now, what, 2022, and it still is a decent fucking film. It still makes me feel like, oh shit, that's right. It kind of throws me still. Like, that fucking storyline still gets me a little bit. Even though I know the ending, it still has a good story, character building, and the whole vibe of the film is just really good.
It just gives the vibe of, like, classic, real scary.
Get it for me.
And for the gore scale, da-da-da-da-da! No, we're gonna definitely
not use that. So on the gore scale, I would go ahead and rate this
savage. I will say that's too high.
I'm going to go ahead and say between bloody and savage because I feel like they used a decent amount of blood. I mean, in the beginning, I think they had that dude's guts hanging out and stuff.
Drew Barrymore was hanging with her intestines hanging out.
Yeah, so they had some scenes where some blood was coming out. But at the same time, I feel like with all the knife fucking play, they could have fucking amped it up a bit. Yeah. These are some facts you may not know about the film. And I don't know. I don't think Ryan knew them. I know I didn't know them before I read them.
Here's number one.
At around 12 minutes at the beginning of the movie, when Casey, Drew Barrymore's parents, come home to find something wrong, her father tells her mother to go to Mackenzie's, which is the same thing Lori, Jamie Lee Curtis, told Lindsay, Kyle Richards, and Tommy Bryan Andrews to do in Halloween from 1978. Check out the shirt. Of which this movie contains many references. I mean, at the party scene, they're watching the fucking Halloween movie, and that was pretty cool. Number two, Drew Barrymore shot all of her scenes in the first 5 days of production. I mean, to me, that just shows how great of an actress she is.
If those scenes would have taken longer than 5 days, I would be worried.
Number three, the use of caller ID increased more than threefold after the release of this film.
Like the special effects of this movie used about 50 gallons of fake blood. Suck on those nuts.
50 gallons. That's a lot of fucking gallons. I mean, I just think about the gallons of milk that you would buy.
Like, and then just 50
of them. In 2007, Wes Craven originally turned down this movie because it was too violent, but reconsidered making one more gory for the hungry fans who continually told him that his best movie was The Hills Have Eyes in 1977. I don't know. I think we need to revisit The Hills Have Eyes because
I don't think I've ever seen The Hills Have Eyes.
I don't think I've seen that version of it. I think I saw a remake. Tonight's beer is Cerberus, a hazy IPA from Ghost Town Brewing. Aggressively hopped at 7% alcohol by volume, with tons of tropicality as well as barks and howls of candied pear, peach, and passion fruit. This beer is oh so fresh and tasty. Thank you for watching this episode of Blood and Brews. We appreciate you guys liking, subscribing,
and hitting that
commenting on the fucking videos.
Thank you for interacting and being involved.
I love talking to you guys, and I'm trying to get this guy more involved in responding back.
I'm trying. We gotta start. We got a good amount of recommendations, so we gotta make sure we watch those movies.
Okay, I agree with you.
I think that's important. The next movie should be one of those movies. Because we're asking for the recommendations, so we need to watch those fucking movies.
For sure.
I think we should start from the top, dude, honestly. Ooh.
From the top?
I'm feeling the fire. I'm feeling the fucking fire! Ugh.
Anyways, have a good night, guys.
We're starting from the top.